or the way that you use words, the way that you don't use words, questions to ask other people when they use these words, because the white supremacists use words as one of their chief tools in manipulating how people think, speak, and act. You're influenced by words or messages in the form of words. That influences what people do. Has a heavy influence on what you value, what you think is important, what you think is not important. Advertising is about words. They will say something is important. You should have one of these. If you're going to be somebody, you should have this necklace around your neck. If you don't have this necklace around your neck that I am going to sell to you, you are nobody. You are nothing. Now, how is that done? That's done by somebody saying that it is. Somebody telling you something is important that you didn't think was important. That's all it is. It's words. And the white supremacists are the masters of words among the people of this planet, particularly when it comes to non-white people. So you have to watch the words that they use. I'm going to remind everybody again, everything in the code book is optional. Everything.
Meaning it's a suggestion.
Yes, these are just suggestions. So if you don't want to take them, I mean, you don't have to. I mean, it's up to you. But this is all designed to help people to communicate better, okay? To interact with each other as compensatory counter-racist companions.
Hmm.
Got that in capital letters.
Yes.
Compensatory counter-racist companions to each other. And that all of your sexual activities be conducted in such a manner as to assist in ending racism and replacing it with justice.
Ooh, wait,
now, I talked about that before.
Yeah.
Right. But all of your sexual, you know, I mean, when you're having sexual intercourse, that's what you're thinking about. This is all in support of ending racism and producing justice.
What?
All right? That's everything is political. Your sexual intercourse is political. All right, that's the way you're supposed to look at it, according to counter-racist what? Counter-racist logic. And says to not engage in sexually, this is number two now, to not engage in sexual intercourse and or in sexual play with any white person as long as white supremacy exists. Now, you have to agree on that. That you do not engage in sexual intercourse and or sexual play with any white person as long as white supremacy exists. And you can say this openly. I mean, not only to each other, but you can say this on a TV talk show or whatnot. I don't engage in sexual intercourse with white people. And give the reason why. Always give the reason. Because you're not trying to shock people or turn people off or have people be controversial. You're not looking for controversy. You're trying to get rid of controversy. All right? By getting what? Understanding. And you say, well, as long as white supremacy exists, you can have it, you know. When the warden is no longer a warden of a prison and the prisoner is no longer a prisoner, then what used to be the warden and what used to be the prisoner of the warden can now have sexual intercourse. That's logical. Why? Because you no longer have that power interaction. One doesn't have power over the other. Everything is mutual. Like all functional relationships, all business transactions are supposed to be mutual. Otherwise, they shouldn't exist if they're not mutual.